Good morning, students. Welcome to computer science class. Today, here I am going to explain the next topic of your syllabus, that is anatomy of computers. Okay? So, before going into the actual topic, let me explain what is a computer, what it will do. Okay? So, computer is an electronic device which accepts the input and instructions from a user. Based on that instructions, it will process the data and it will produce the output. Okay, so to perform these calculations, to manipulate the data, whatever stored inside the system, there are two units in the system which are responsible for all these activities. That two units are nothing but hardware and software. Okay. So, hardware and software, you can say this. System is a collection of two units. So, as I said, computer is a collection of two units. Okay, it consists of two units, which these two units are responsible for all the activities done by the system. Okay, so together, these two units is called as the anatomy of computer. Okay. So, computer system, there are two units inside the system. One is a hardware and the second one is a software. Okay. Again, hardware is divided into input and output devices, CPU, memory, interface unit. Okay. Input and output, CPU, memory and interface unit. Again, the software is divided into two categories. One is a system software and the second one is an application software. Okay, you take screenshot of this. Next, I will explain what is the hardware, what is the software, and what is the system software, application software, hard input and output, CPU, memory, everything I will explain. So, in the exam, they will give you the question like anatomy of computer. Then you need to write what is the computer, and next, what is the anatomy of computer. Next, you draw this chart in the exam. Okay, so you take screenshot of this. So we complete software of a system, because in this hardware unit we have four tools. That four, after completing a software, I will complete. Okay, so software, first we'll complete what is the software, how many types of software we have. Okay, software is a set of programs. Okay, what is a software? Software is a set of programs which are designed. Software is a set of programs which are designed to perform a specific task. Okay, so what is a software? Software is a set of programs which are designed to perform a specific task, and this every program is a collection of instructions. Okay, software is a set of programs, and every program is a set of instructions which are designed to perform a specific task. Okay. Again, this software is divided into two categories. One is a system software and the second one is a application software. First one is a system software and the second one is a application software. Okay. Come to the system software. What is the system software? Draw this. So, while watching a video, you try to make a running notes. Okay. We'll give you the material. But if you write the running notes, you will get more clarity on the video. What I am explaining, you will get more clarity. Okay, take running notes. You draw this. So So software is divided into two categories. One is a system software and the second one is the application software. Now we'll discuss about the system software. What is a system software? In the name itself, you have a definition. The software which is designed to run the system, to control the system, to control the hardware. Okay, so that software is called as a system software. Understood? The software which is designed to control the system hardware, to control the file system, to control the interface between a user and the system. All this, that software is called as a system software. So this software is generally designed by the manufacturer to control the system. And these softwares are designed by using a low-level languages. Understood? So system software is designed to control the system hardware. Okay? And it is designed using a low-level languages. Understood? And who will design this? The manufacturer. The manufacturer company who are designing this system hardware, only that person will design this. And these softwares are mainly used to provide interactivity between a system hardware and the user. What is the main use of this? It will provide the interactivity between user and the system. Understood? And these softwares are designed by using a low-level languages. Understood? And here, you can take an example is, in a desktop system, you can take a Windows. System software is also called as an operating system. Okay, system software is also called as an operating system. And you can take examples of this operating system, Windows you can take, Android you can take. Okay, so these are all operating systems which are mainly designed to run the system, to operate the system. Okay, now you write key points of this. What are the main key points in this list? These are very close to the system. Means they are directly interact with the system. They are designed using a low level language. Less interactive. And next, smaller in size. Next, difficult to manipulate. You read these key points? Difficult to manipulate. Next, low level languages. Difficult to design. Okay. So you understood? System software is designed to operate the system, to run the system. Okay. And who will design the system software? The manufacturer will design this software. So what key points you have in a system software? It is very close to the system because these softwares are designed in a low level languages. So it is very close to the system because the system will understand low level languages only. Next, it is less interactive. Actually, it is used to provide interactivity between a user and the system at the very beginning. Less interactivity we have. We don't have that much interactivity that we have with the application softwares. Next, it is very smaller in size. Difficult to manipulate because these softwares are designed by the manufacturer. So, it is difficult to manipulate every time these softwares. Next, it is difficult to design also. And one more thing is, if you want to even start the system, you need an operating system. Okay, you need a system software. Without system software, you cannot operate the system. Example, imagine you have a Samsung mobile. You have an Android operating system. If Android is not installed inside your mobile, how will you operate your mobile? It is not possible. Similarly, if it is not loaded in your system, if the system software is not loaded in your system, it is not possible to operate your system. Understood? So this is the first software. This should be the first software to be loaded in your system. If the operating system is not loaded in your system, it is difficult to operate your system. Understood? If operating system is there, then only you can load
other application software. If the operating system is not there, you cannot run other application software, because you won't get you cannot operate your system also. Understand? So this is about your system software. What is the system software? The software which is designed to operate your system, that is called as a system software. System software is also called as a operating system. And this should be the first software should be loaded in your system in order to operate. It is used to control your system hardware and the software also. Understood? And it will provide the platform to load other application softwares. Clear? And these softwares are designed by the manufacturer. It is very difficult to manipulate and design. Clear? Now we'll discuss about the system software, the application software. The second one is the application software. Okay, application software. In the name itself, you have a definition. So, this software is a application software which is designed to perform a specific task. Okay, it is not designed to operate your system. It is designed to perform a specific task. Example, you can take MS Word. You can take different MS Word, Excel, PowerPoint. That softwares will come under the application software only. So that softwares are designed to perform a specific task. Okay, these softwares are not used to operate your system. Okay, and these softwares are loaded when there is an operating system inside the system. If there is no operating system, so these softwares are not loaded. Understood? So, these softwares are designed to perform a specific task only. So, these softwares are designed to satisfy a particular organization or particular specific purpose these softwares are used. Understood? So when there is an operating system inside your system, then only these softwares are loaded. Example for this application software is, you can take Word, you can take MS Word, Excel. These are all applications only. These are not means whatever softwares you have other than your operating system, all the softwares will come under your application software. Whatever softwares you know, you write that software as an example in your exam. Understood? So, when this application softwares are loaded, when there is an operating system inside your system, then only these softwares are loaded. Understood? Now, key points of this, you write this application software, characteristics actually. This first point, it is close to the user, because these are designed based on the user requirement. The next one, it is easy to design and easy to manipulate. And these are easy to understand. Next, easy to manipulate. Next, it is more interactive, because using the softwares you can perform different types of tasks. So these are more interactive, and it is these are of bigger size compared to operating system software. Understood? These are the characteristics of application software. So what are the application software? Application softwares are designed to perform a specific task. So other than your all operating system, whatever softwares you have, all the softwares will come under application softwares only. And these application software are very close to the user, because these softwares will be used by the user only. And whatever system software is there, that is used by the system to operate the system. Understood? You have these key points? So, sometimes in the exam, they will ask you to differentiate also. Write the difference between your system software and the application software. So, just you need to remember, system software is designed to operate the system. Application software is designed to perform a specific task. Okay? Size is, operating system size is small compared to the application. Application size is bigger compared to the operating system. It is very easy. So, whatever key points I have given, that you write as a difference. Okay? I hope you all understood what is a software. So, software is a set of instructions, set of programs, and programs consist of set of instructions. Okay, now again, how many types of software we have? Two types. One is a system software, the second one is application software. System software is used to operate the system. Okay, example is your operating system. Application software is designed to perform a specific task. Okay, and what type of task they want, that instructions are given by the user. Now we'll discuss about the hardware. Hardware, okay, already I have explained hardware. Again, hardware is divided into four categories. So before going into in depth of hardware, first I'll explain what is the hardware. Hardware is nothing but a physical components of the system. Okay, physical components of the system like a keyboard, mouse, CPU, monitor. Physical components of the system which you can touch, which you can feel. So that components will come under hardware. Understand? So what is a hardware? Hardware is a physical components of the system. Clear? And whatever hardware devices you have in the system, all those will come under hardware category only. Clear? Again, this hardware is divided into four categories. Inputs and output devices. You can give memory, CPU first, right? CPU, memory, interface unit. Here, actually each component itself is a essay question. Okay, here just I'll give you the definitions and all. But when you will come to this actual topic, no, you will get these questions in the exam in essay type. Okay. So, input and output, it is also essay. CPU is also essay question. And memory is also essay. And this will come under in short. Okay. You remember this. Just here I will give you only the definition. What is the input and output devices? What is the CPU? What is the memory and interfaces unit? Only a brief discussion I will give. But in the exam, in essay, you need to write these. Well, essay means minimum 4 pages you have to write. Understood? These 3 questions will come under essay. Okay? First, you take screenshot of this. Next, I will explain what are the input and what are the output devices and CPU and all. Input and output will take first. Hardware, first one is actually this will come under the devices. Peripherals, devices. Devices divided into two types, input and output. The hardware is actually divided into two things here, input and output. Input and output. In the name itself, you have a definition. Actually these two are the part of the hardware. As I already said, hardware is nothing but the physical components which you can touch, which you can feel. Okay, so which are physically present, that will come under the hardware. So in the hardware also, there are two types of hardware. Some devices which we use to give input to the user.
that devices will come under input devices. And we have some devices which are used to present output to the user. That devices will come under output devices. Okay, so the devices which are used to give input to the system, that devices are called as a input devices. The devices which are used to display output to the user, that devices are called as a output devices. So here I am giving you the input devices examples: keyboard, the second one is a mouse, scanner, touch screen, they all will come under input devices. Using all these devices will give input to the system. Okay, understood? If you want to enter anything into the system, how will you enter? Using a keyboard. So keyboard is a one of the major input device, and a mouse is called as a pointing device. Using that also you can enter input to the system. And how will you enter? By clicking on that. Okay, now scanner, I think you all know the scanner. It is used to scan the your paper, physical copy, and that will create a image inside your system. Okay, so this is also used to supply input to the system. Next, touch screen. Touch screen is also input device. You can see this touch screen in ATM centers, or your mobile is also touch only. So whenever you touch a particular object, that will be considered as an input to the system. Each and every device in detail I will explain. Just timing I am giving an overview. Okay, now come to the output devices. What is the output? Who will give the output? Whatever output, whatever result you are getting from a system, that is called as output. Whatever you are giving to the system, whatever instructions, whatever data you are giving to a system, that is called as an input. Whatever output, whatever result you are getting from a system, that is called as an output. Okay, so output, how the system will give the output, where it will give. See, system, whatever it want to display, that will display on the monitor. Okay, so output devices, the monitor is one example, and the printer is one more example. Here you will get a soft copy, here you will get a hard copy. Speaker is also output device. It will display the sound. Understood? Monitor display the output, and next printer is also display the output, and the speakers are also display the output. But what type of output they are giving to the user is different. Monitor display the output in the form of soft copy, whereas printer display the output in the form of hard copy. And next, the speaker will display the output in the form of audio. What type of output they are producing, that is different. Understood? So this is about first component of your hardware. Now come to the CPU. CPU, the full form of CPU is central processing unit. Okay, it is a brain of the computer. See, if you don't have example, if your brain is stuck, or if you don't have brain, how a human being will work? No, it is not possible. Without brain, the human being will not work. Similarly, without CPU, the system will not work. So whatever instructions you have given, whatever arithmetic or logical instructions you have given, all the instructions are performed by the CPU. So that is why CPU is called as brain of the system. Okay, what CPU is called? CPU is called as brain of the system. Okay, whatever whatever instructions has to be done in the system, all the instructions are done by CPU only. Understand? Now what is the next one? Memory. Next two component, memory. Okay, so memory is nothing but, memory is again divided into a primary. Next one is a secondary. Actually, what is a primary memory and what is a secondary memory? Later I will explain. First, I'll give you the what is the definition of the memory. See, if you want to store something, if you have created one file, you want to store inside the system. Where you will store? In the system, in a memory will store. Okay, so in the computer, memory is a storage unit. Example, in your mobile, you have an internal storage and SD card. Both, what is the use of that to do? That two are used to store information. That two are used to store images, text, files, videos, audios. They are used, actually, what is the purpose of that internal storage and SD card? That two are used to store the information. Similarly, inside the system, if you want to store anything, then we'll use a memory. Okay, so memory is the storage unit inside the system. Whatever files the user will store, whatever files the user will create, all those files are stored inside the memory only. Understood? So again, the memory is divided into two categories. One is a primary memory and the second one is a secondary memory. Understood? So primary memory, whatever information you are currently storing, currently entering, and whatever files you are executing. So all the files which you are going to execute, all the files should be in a primary memory. Understood? And the size of the primary memory is very less compared to the secondary memory. Now, secondary memory is also one type of memory. It is used, but the size of the secondary memory is very big. Means it, you can store large volume of data in the secondary memory. Understood, all of you? But when there is no power, whatever content you save inside the primary memory, that will be lost. But if there is no power also, whatever content you saved inside the secondary memory, that will be resided in your secondary memory. Okay, in detail in the next classes I will discuss this. Next to interfaces unit. Interfaces. This will also come under interfaces unit. Means whatever devices you have. The next one is the interface unit. Interface unit connects your CPU with the memory. Okay, means the CPU is used to execute the instructions and it will execute the instructions. But where are the instructions? In the memory. So that instruction should come from your memory to your CPU. So this interface unit connects your CPU with the memory. Understood? Then only the data can be transferred from your CPU to the memory and memory to the CPU. Here we have a data bus, address bus, control bus. So we have a different purpose of this. In the next class, we'll discuss about that. Understood? So this is about your anatomy of computers. Anatomy is here is nothing but the complete structure. The complete structure of your system. So the complete structure of your system is with the two units. One is an input unit, one is a hardware, and the second one is a software. Okay, in the hardware, all the physical components will come, and in the software, all the programs, all the instructions will come. Both hardware and software, both are interdependent. Okay, so hardware, we have four things inside the, means hardware is again divided into four categories. In the software, there are two categories. One is the system software and the second one is the application software. Clear? System software is used to operate the system, and application software is designed to perform a specific task given by the user. Understood? And hardware, the physical devices you can touch inside the system, that are called as a hardware. Hardware is again divided into four categories. One is the input and output, the second one is the memory, third one is the CPU, and the fourth one is the interface unit. Clear? This is about your anatomy of computer. In the next class, we'll discuss about the input and output devices. Because as I already said, input and output device is not the short answer. It is an essay question. So in detail, we'll discuss tomorrow about this input and output devices. Thank you.